This is a story about thinking ahead, even way ahead. We've all heard about the race between companies and countries to develop artificial intelligence. But it turns out that there's another race going on, one among entirely different approaches to AI and what they're racing to achieve.
Generally, we think the cost of innovation is collapsing here.
It is going to transform our lives. We're going to look back and see this as a hugely important era.
This is obviously the most disruptive technology in the history of mankind.
At the center of many of the latest AI breakthroughs are large language models, or LLMs, the ChatGPTs and Geminis of this world. But as powerful as they are becoming, we learn more every day about their limitations, how they can be prone to errors, hallucinations, and uncertainty. Jack Hidary has built a business around what he calls large quantitative models, which are trained on numbers and data rather than on prose. His company, SandboxAQ, spun off from Alphabet in 2022.
What we can do is we can take the equations of biology, of chemistry, of physics, of engineering, and we can train an AI on those. And that's the world now of large quantitative models, LQMs. And this world of LQMs impacts 80% of our economy and drives massive innovation in the companies that use them. And so you have large language models on the one hand, and from a business point of view, they're mainly there to cut some costs. If you have, say, $30 million of costs every year in your company, you could probably start lopping off 10, 15, 20 million of customer service costs per year. And that's gonna be a great savings for your company. But when it comes to creating new product, billions of dollars of new revenue, that's not really going to be a large language model. That's going to be an LQM, a large quantitative model.
Where are we in developing LQMs?
LQMs are now proliferating in the B2B land. So it's less about consumers using LQMs, but it's really about businesses using LQMs. And right now, we announced at SandboxAQ that we're working with Sanofi, for example, a top 10 pharma company, using LQMs to advance their work in life-saving medicines. We announce work with chemical companies such as Aramco using LQMs to upvalue the hydrocarbons coming out so we can create new products, products that will not be burned in the atmosphere, but rather be put into various kinds of vehicles and others to lightweight and to add value to those industries as well.
There's a lot of money being invested in AI right now. A lot, hundreds of billions of dollars literally being invested. From what you understand, where are the places to look for good investments? Or even better, what would you advise an investor to look out for, both on the upside and the downside, in considering investing in AI?
There's two real ways to play the AI future. One is to focus on a number of mainly private AI companies that are out there now, and you know, various people and various banks are able to put together vehicles to invest in these. And so that's one way to really focus on that. The second is to look at the public markets. And when we look at the public markets, again, you can look at the hyperscalers such as Amazon, Microsoft, Google, and others, and you could place your bets there, because essentially those are AI-driven companies at this point. But another way to make your AI play that actually may be more fruitful is to look at industry by industry, David, and understand who are going to be the AI winners and AI losers in the pharmaceutical industry, in the energy industry, in the telco industry, in the financial services sector. Each of these are $8, $10, $15 trillion sectors. And the winners and losers there are going to really determine billions and billions of dollars of value of market cap difference as those two groups diverge. The winners, who are embracing AI, and the laggards, who are not embracing AI fast enough.
Whoever the winners and losers might be tomorrow, picking them today is anything but certain.